Hey guys, Paisteboy here at the Syracuse Big East Power Sports Show 2023. Stick around.
Look at this new 858 engine from Articat. So it's got new power valve system. I mean, it's pretty badass. Don't know a lot of the technical stuff about it, but what I've seen online is quite an advancement.
Yeah. Right?
And it's got the V-Force 3 lights on it. Alright, this is the new display from Articat that will be available in
2025.
Sleds as an option. Let's see, click that. Get your speedometer and tachometer and some other displays down there. And they're good size, where those are usually hard to read when you're riding, but that's about as big as you can make them. They're a lot better than other gauges out there. Let's see if we can get to, there's the mapping.
This is just the slides.
this gauge, from what I saw from Snowtrack's video, is awesome. It's leaps and bounds even better than the 7S and crystal clear. So if you get a chance, we're getting a new Articat next year. You might want to pick one of these up, and you could upgrade your
2024 catalyst
sled with this gauge here. There we go. I'm going to get a quick shot of this Articat ZR600 catalyst. Brand new, 2024. This, from what I understand, you could upgrade next year if you want to get their brand new display, which looks badass. I'm kind of jealous that Skidoo hadn't stepped it up to that level, that that new display that they're coming out with for next year will be the leader of the pack as far as technology goes with GPS and whatnot in a display. The Skidoo one now is going to be in third place. So this is the Articat booth, and looking like Articat is back in the game. Because next year they're going to have that brand new engine that's over there with the 858. You can check that out online and see if that might be something you're interested in. If you're a cat guy, you're back. We got our Polaris's over here. Polaris is another leader with their engines, their suspensions, and their displays, the 7S, like this one here. So, you know, yeah, the Skidoo definitely has it when it comes to the smart shocks, but now they're lagging in the display department. Even though their 10 1/4 inch display is a great display, as far as visually, it lacks in the GPS department since you need to use your phone with it. Hey, how's it going?
Still kind of
tough, huh?
here.
Hey,
good, how you doing? What are we doing?
I'm getting spy photos.
Oh. My shoes? I wear New Balance because I'm old. All right, so this sled here is an MXZ Adrenaline 850 E-Tech. Okay, it's a Gen 5. And it's got the two generations ago display. So that's 7.2 inch display. Doesn't have any features to hook up to your phone or anything like that. No GPS integrated or nothing. But it does what it needs to do. So there you go. Pick one up. So we got the Renegade Adrenaline 900 Ace Turbo here. It's a 137 inch track. And he's got the super tiny gauge. So, if you didn't notice, I don't know what's going on with these sleds these days. They got Adrenalines here, a lot of Adrenalines. They got the Neo over here, which is an even lower model. Maybe they're trying to get people that don't want to spend $15,000, $20,000 on a sled to get interested in the sport again. Because you've got the competition model over there. It's an MXZ XRS. And I believe that's a 137. So, and that does have the brand new, well, not brand new, it was brand new last year, 10 1/4 inch display. And it also has this guy here that gives you that turbo boost. It's a special liquid formula you put in there, which gives you your turbo, I believe. I only saw a couple of videos on that, so don't quote me on it. But yes, it is an 850 E-Tech Turbo R MXZ XRS. So, as long as you're not pinning it all day, I guess it lasts a while. It holds a gallon of that special fluid. Here's a 600R Renegade Adrenaline. So everything's Adrenaline. And I know they did change the way they're doing things. So I'm kind of confused because I thought the MXZ line was going to be all two strokes and the Renegade line was going to be all four strokes for 2024, but I guess I'm mistaken, unless this is a 2023. Nope, 2024. So that's what we have. And then we have the Lynx, a couple of Lynx here. The Rave RE and the X Terrain. They're both 850 E-Techs. I believe 137. I don't know, this one might be 137 with the 3500. This might be 144 with the 3700 millimeters. Alright guys, I want to thank you for watching. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Check the links in the description. Go like me, Paisteboy, on Facebook and Instagram. Maybe check out another video after this. And we will see you next time, maybe on the trail. Take care.